More than a year ago, a U.S. ambassador and three other Americans were killed in an uprising in Benghazi, Libya. The questions about the incident, why it happened, how it happened, whether it could have been avoided, have never completely gone away. Today, after dozens of hearings and interviews, the Senate Intelligence Committee issued its own bipartisan conclusions. Adam Goldman of The Washington Post joins us now to talk about them. So how did the Senate Intelligence Committee's findings differ from what we've heard about? We've heard so much about this Benghazi episode. Was there anything different that they discovered today?
No, I think they came to the same conclusion as other reports, that what happened in Benghazi was preventable. I think what was new about the report was the detail they went into, and that in itself was extraordinary. The whole report was released, and we really got a blow-by-blow of what happened, and there weren't very many redactions in this report.
In what way do they say it was preventable?
That it was clear, the report lays out in very clear terms that there was more than enough evidence to suggest that the security environment in Benghazi was deteriorating quickly. In fact, there were 20 security incidents in Benghazi in August before, and the State Department had received repeated warnings that the situation was getting worse. And the CIA on the ground, which was operating out of an annex about a mile away from the diplomatic compound, also had major concerns and had done a briefing about terrorism activity in the area.
And that annex that you mentioned, the military knew nothing about the CIA annex that where this all happened?
Yeah, one of the things the report highlighted was a lack of communication. AFRICOM, which was in charge of Africa, did not know the CIA was operating out of that annex.
So were they able to sufficiently protect them even after the event began?
No. The report found that there weren't available resources in the region to respond in case of an emergency. And what the report lays out is a military contingent from Tripoli actually responded to what happened, but they don't arrive in Benghazi in the airport until about 1 o'clock. They don't get to the annex itself, which was already under fire, until hours later.
And they're not notified of this attack by the State Department. So the State Department has dropped the ball here.
Well, the State Department does notify the CIA at about 9:40 p.m. on September 11th. The annex, people from the annex leave there about 30 minutes later. And when they get there, they're immediately engaged in a firefight.
There are some amazing details about how that firefight unfolded, including people going to the roof, breaking open a skylight, trying to let air in order to rescue the ambassador, who by then was trapped.
Yeah, it was laid out in harrowing detail in some parts of the report. One diplomatic security agent trying to take the ambassador with him and rescue him and go through a window, almost losing consciousness. The report points out that the attackers used diesel fuel to light the compound on fire, and there was thick smoke. It was really, it was really a tough situation.
Now, the heart of the political argument here has always been about who knew what when, and what the cause was of that, of the uprising in the first place. Was there any new light shed on that?
No. One of the things the report says was on September 18th, 7 days after that the attack, the FBI and CIA was able to review security footage and come to the determination there were no protests. They weren't able to, and the IC, the intelligence community, wasn't able to correct the record until, 6 days later. But by that time, the narrative had already been set.
And part of the narrative, at least a couple of weeks ago, we heard reports that, in fact, this was not the video, the video that sparked the protest, that there was an al-Qaeda link, or there was not an al-Qaeda link. I feel like every time we hear a report about this, it says the opposite of what the last report said.
Well, I think this is what we know. Right now, there wasn't any evidence that core al-Qaeda, Zawahiri from Pakistan, orchestrated this attack. What we do know is that terrorist organizations did participate in it. So, is it al-Qaeda or is it terrorism? And does it really matter?
We don't know what the link necessarily might be. The title is not the issue.
Right. And the FBI...
But it wasn't a spontaneous attack, is I guess the...
They describe it as opportunistic.
Yeah.
And there were elements on the ground in Benghazi that took advantage of this moment. And it's not clear if the militias themselves were actually coordinating.
Very interesting detail that I had never seen before, which is that in the process of this FBI investigation, 15 witnesses have since been killed?
not witnesses, people who might have
cooperated
or the support of the investigation or support of the U.S. And that in itself is chilling. And while the report doesn't say Libya was hampering the investigation, I can tell you through my own reporting that Libya has been hampering the investigation.
The government itself.
Well, in particular the FBI, which is very, very frustrated. It's been very difficult to interview witnesses on the ground in Libya.
Which is maybe why it took so long for this report to come out?
No, I think the minority view, the Republicans on the committee say in the report that it took so long to come out because the White House obstructed it and the State Department didn't provide the information they wanted.
Adam Goldman of The Washington Post, thank you.
Thank you.